Bye. Namaste, 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 Nama उपादान में अहिंसा के बाद वृंदावन धाम दर्शन करवा और साधुसंग करवा सभा को लाभ करे शास्त्र वचन साधु संगे धाम दर्शन यही मात्र चाहे संसार जीते आर बनवस्त नाय धाम दर्शन को कहले साधु संगी मध्य गुरुपाद को बोलते हैं धाम दर्शन को कहले कान दिए धाम दर्शन करते हैं चोख दिए धाम दर्शन है ना धामेर महात्मा जी हमारा श्रवण ना करी ठीक ठीक हमारे धाम दर्शन है ना धामेर महात्मा श्रवण कर ले धामेर को क्या का हमारे जे हमारे तभी तो कृष्ण दास हमारे भगवान के भुने मार कारगरे हम लोग खाची जीव नित्य कृष्ण दास एक था भूले मायार नफर होया चिरकाल भूले कभु राजा कभु प्रजा कभु मित्र शूद्र कभु सुखी कभु दुखी कभु कीट पुत्र कभु स्वर्गीय कभु मर्त्य नरक बा कभु कभु देव कभु दैत्य कभु दास प्रभु एई भावे आमरा संसार नागर दवा हबुलु खाची शास्त्री बोलछेन संसार भ्रमित कोनो भगवान जी गुरु कृष्ण प्रसाद पाए भक्ति रता बीज माली होया सही बीज करे आरोपम सवार के कंगल करे सितम उपजिया वनलता ब्रह्मण भिदिराय विरजा ब्रह्मलोक तदुपरि जाय तदुपरि जाय का बल वृंदावन कृष्ण चरण कर्म वृक्षे करे हरहन तहा विस्तारित हिया बाकी प्रेम फल सही बिचारे हमरा नित्य भगवान दास भगवान सेवा किंतु हमरा इस संसार के भोग को देखिए हमरा मार्ग पर पड़ रहे जी कृष्ण वही मुख या भगवान चकरे माया निकटस्थ माया करे जबरिया धरे पिशाची पाई निकला मतिक संहाय माया किंतु हमरा भगवान के भूले ये माया का सुध करछि किंतु जब हमरा साधु संग पे जाय सदगुरु पाए भगवान कथा जब हमरा रुचि आसे तहर बुझते में निश्चय हमरा आस्ते आस्ते भगवान दिखे हमरा अग्रसर होते पारबो जतदिन पर्यंत हमारे भगवान कथा रुचि ना आसबे साधु संगे रुचि ना आसबे तदवी हमारा मार हाथ की इसके लिए बात कोनो उपाय नहीं एकमात्र मार हाथ की हमारा मुक्ति पेते चाहे ताहले श्रीयतां श्रीयतां नित्यं नित्यों के हरि का श्रवण करते हमें हमारा धर्म सब समय के साथ सत्संग पाएगा सब समय सत्संग होगा बातें दी साधु संग विभिन्न प्रकार है ग्रंथ में भी साधु संग पढ़ा जाए हमरा बाइट में से भी ग्रंथ अलग अलग रही गोस्वामी वाले ग्रंथ महावीर वाले रचित कीर्तन जो कि हमरा आलोचना करी हमारे साधु संग है ताकि हमारे साधु संग है अनंत काल धरे भगवान भूले নিত্য মুক্ত নিত্য কৃষ্ণ চরণে অন্য নিত্য বদ্ধ নিত্য ভঙ্গে সংসার নরকাদি যারা নিত্য বদ্ধ তারা নিত্য করে সংসার চিন্তা করা যদি করছে আবার যারা নিত্য মুক্ত তারা সবসময় ভগবানের নাম গুণে কীর্তন ভগবানের সেবা সংদর্শন এই নিয়ে তারা মত হয়ে আছে সেই জন্য প্রত্যেকটা জীবের তিন তিন শরীর আছে স্থূল শরীর সূক্ষ্ম শরীর আত্মা শরীর স্থূল শরীরের খারাপ এই জগতের স্থূল শরীর হচ্ছে প্রাকৃত শরীর ভূমি জল আকাশে তার গঠিত সূক্ষ্ম শরীর মন বুদ্ধি অহংকার আত্ম শরীর আত্মার আত্মার উপর নির্ভর করছে ভূমি বায়ুখ মনোবুদ্ধি অহংকার ইঞ্জন ভিনা প্রকৃতি অযোধা এই আট প্রকার প্রকৃতি দিয়ে আমাদের দুটো শরীরকে সৃষ্টি করেছে পাহাড় বলে ঘাটি দিয়েছে
Then Maharaj explained that in our all the Goswami Granthas, in all the kirtans of Mahajans, everywhere it is explained that without Sadhu Sangha, nobody is able to get liberation, nobody is able to get pure bhakti. Then he started explaining that there are two kind of jivas, one is Nitya Bhadha and another is Nitya Mukta. Nitya Bhadha is one who has no taste for Sadhu Sangha, Harikatha or serving Vaishnavas or having taste for Rajmandal Parikrama or any other activity which is sporting Krishna Bhajan. But Nitya Mukta, he has always taste for Harikatha. He always wants to serve pure Vaishnavas at any cost. He has no other desire except this. He has only desire. One thing is in his heart, that how I can please my Gurudev and how I can get pure bhakti. That's only his desire. Then Maharaj started explaining that a living being is part and parcel of Lord Krishna and he is eternal. And this reason, Vaishnava reason, it's not actually reason, it is for everybody, each and every living entity. But in this time we see that there are so many religions, like Muslim religion, Christianity, Buddhist, and so many other religions on the name of religion, but they are not actually religion. Why? Because they are not eternal. Some of the religions started before 1000 years or some 1500 years back or some 2000 years back. That's why, because they are not eternal, and in the same way they are not going to establish for so long. After some time there will be no sign of those religions. And this is eternal religion, Vaishnava religion. That's why all the living entities has to try to get the real religion. Then Maharaj changed his topic little bit and he said that he started explaining the glories of Ekadashi. He said that Ekadashi is known as Madhava Tithi, which can please Madhava. By observing Ekadashi, one can get pure bhakti. Why? Because it is known as the mother of bhakti. By observing Ekadashi, one can get the pure bhakti in the lotus feet of Lord Krishna. Then he says that we always give diet to our body, which is made with five elements. We give diet to our subtle body also, which is consist of man, buddhi, ahankar. But those who give food, who nourish, who give the diet to their soul, they are really intelligent. Otherwise, those who don't stress on Harikatha, Hari Bhajan or the right of soul, they are not intelligent, they are foolish. Then Maharaj gave the example of Parikshit Maharaj, that when he was hearing Harikatha with his full heart for the benefit of his soul, he was thinking that how I can get rid of cycle of birth and death. And at that time, he didn't feel that I am hungry or I am thirsty. He didn't waste it even a single minute. And for 7 days, he was continuously hearing Harikatha. And he followed all those things. Then Maharaj said that, but we are not Mukta Purushas, we are Bhakta Jivas. In this situation, we have taste for all the worldly things, Vishaya things. And we are looking in that. But Krishna is so merciful that he had given his prasadam, he had given his name, so that somehow or other we can have taste for bhakti, somehow or other we can get taste for Krishna, somehow or other we can enter into Guru Bhakti also. Then by explaining all these things, he said that if ruchi is not coming in our heart, real attachment for the bhajan is not coming in our heart, then we must understand that we have done so many sinful activities in so many lives. But if now we want to become intelligent and we really want to get bhakti, then we have to follow the path which is shown by real and bona fide gurus. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. ज्ञान विज्ञान शब्द नमो
Oh, very qualified.
हरे नाम केवल गौरव नाम देव नाम कर नानो जस जापी शक्ति पाप हर निर्हर ने हरे तावत कर्तुम न सकोति पादकम पादकी कृष्ण नाम में भगवान के नाम में पापों को हरण करने की जितनी शक्ति है इतनी शक्ति है जिसको पाप लोग कर नहीं सकते। भक्तिविनोद ठाकुर हैज कोटेड दिस श्लोक फ्रॉम विष्णु बृहद विष्णु पुराण कि जो नाम करते हैं उनके लिए किसी प्रकार की प्रायश्चित की आवश्यकता नहीं है। No need of doing any prayership. Prayership is it? No need of doing any of एक बार हम लोग आसाम जा रहे थे, गुरु जी के साथ में हम लोग दर्शन ग्रहण में बैठे और गुरु जी के साथ में बैलगाड़ी पर चढ़ करके खुद जा रहा और लोग सब पैदल चल रहे और मैं गुरु जी के साथ में जा रहा। देखा क्या वन साइड आर गोइंग वी वेर गोइंग सो मेनी अबाउट 15 टू 25 वैष्णव वी वेर गोइंग बामन भरत कुछ पद विक्रम महाराज ने लॉ एंड आई वाज सेटिंग ऑन द बुलवार्ड विद माय और सम टाइम स्टॉप आई सॉ दैट In a farm, a farmer was born and he was full of what? Soft wood. And he saw that all the Brahmacharyas and Sannyasis were doing kirtan. And Guru Maharaj was on the front, on the block. He at once left his plowing. And ran away. And he did so, Dandav Pranas. I am weeping bitterly. We could not imagine the why he is weeping. Can you get Kansya Maharaj? Dharna Maharaj. Tapara said, Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, oh, stop. This person. He told, weeping, that I am your disciple. I am very weak. Rite of initiation. Also, second thing, Diksha. We know that Diksha is Hari name or not the second trade. But Diksha means, you tell like second initiation. We don't tell second initiation. Initiation means a diksha. So he has Harinam also and diksha. When he returned to his home, 4 days began to be weak. He began to give up his prey, tulsi mala, tilak, everything. And in bad association, he began to take fishes, eggs, and all that. And then he will question that I have done so. Now after 10 or 15 years I am taking your darshan. I am very grateful. Please do my any prayaschit for me. What should I do? I want to take that. Guru Maharaj told that you should come where I am going. And begin. He was really so much. Guru Maharaj told that no need of doing anything. No sacrifice for nothing. Guru Maharaj took separate thread and gave and told that you should come. And never in this life you should promise that I will never think of it. So he promised and Guru Maharaj told that Mani Naksha Vishnutam is most highest class of Rashi, right? We have seen. Not only one, I have seen so many times. So when it becomes like so. Also, follow up. This is the egg question. So, sometimes I see that other Vaishnavas, they make fire sacrifice and so many things and dance and donation. This was not for me. Otherwise, it will be very big offense in the name of Harina. बस वो प्रतिज्ञा करे कान पकड़ करके और नरे बाप बस यही प्रश्न और अरे नाम संकीर्तन करना नामो अश्य जाति शक्ति पाप भर दे रहा है पाप इतना पाप नहीं कर सकता जितना कि नाम में पाप रुक कर देख सकती है पर फिर You have to look at
there is such shakti, such potency in Harinam to remove the reactions of sinful activities that it does not matter how many sinful reactions you commit, even it is not possible for you to commit as many sinful reactions as Harinam can take away. Therefore, no press to or atonement is necessary.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur in translation. Bhaktivinoda Siska Kumbhar Kare. Kono prayas chikuta. Nahi name shaman. Atevo karvam tyag kare. Prayas chit ki to bhakya ye batlaya gaya hai ki kaise din ko in Padma Purana. Jadi aparad bhi hai यदि कोई वैष्णव जिसके चरणों में या गुरु के चरणों में अपराध किया तो उसे बार बार क्षमा मांगो नहीं मांगने नहीं यदि क्षमा करते हैं तो भी मांगते जाओ रो रो करके और यदि वो वैष्णव और गुरु नहीं है तो क्या करो पंडित गुरु के चरणों में क्षमा मांगो और अनुताप के साथ में हरि नाम निरंतर किसी से वो अपराध तो प्रायश्चित तो इसे बढ़कर के और कोई नहीं है यहाँ तक कि पाप नवापराध को निरंतर नाम करने से किंतु अनुताप के साथ यदि अनुताप नहीं है नाम करेंगे ये नाम के बल में हो जाएगा और उस वैष्णव की उपेक्षा करेंगे तो नहीं पढ़ो
If one has committed sinful activities, there's no method of atonement except for the chanting of the holy names. One should chant continuously with the feelings of regret. If one is chanting, but there are no feelings of regret, and one is not taking shelter of Guru and Vaishnavas, then this atonement will not take place.
पाप साध नहीं तो पाप है तो पाप है हैं कैसा तुम्हारा बोलते किंतु शांत सुनिए जी प्रारंभ होते हैं तो आशे उठा हैं हैं यह तो भक्ति ग्रहण ठाकुर के जाके कौनो उदाहरण दिखाएं ये तो भक्ति ग्रहण ठाकुर कोट करेंगे दार सब देते हैं एक कृष्ण नाम है जो तो पाप भरे पाप श्राद्ध करना ही तो पाप क्या नाम है भक्ति बोलते हैं ये हमारे विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर जी की टीका में अपनी कहा है अजामिल ने जब भी अपने बेटे का नाम रखा नारायण बस वही उसका नाम पास हो गया और उसके पाप सब दूर हो गए और इसके बाद में जो जो नाम किया वो बहुत से लोग इसको ग्रहण नहीं कर पाते तो हमारी तो उनकी मतलब वही श्रद्धा है भक्ति भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर श्री और कृष्णा चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर क्यों रूप गोस्वामी जैसे जो कहा जाता है उसको वेद की तरफ में हम उसको विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर बोले ये प्रथम तारा वही चीज हम आप आते थे तार मुक्ति पड़ेगा और बाकी नाम भूल जाओ लोग what I told. But the Vishwanatha Bhakti has told that when Ajami kept the name of Ishan Narayan, he was himself so much pop, sinful. But even by his old sanskar, he kept the name and he became Namakas. And after that, what he told, oh Narayan, come on, oh Narayan, come on. And all the life, puna puna, bhakti kamushina, dushka puna. This कभी कभी होता है अजामिल का यदि पहले नाम से ही उसका पाप सब कुछ हो गया तो पीछे से पाप क्यों किया इफ द नेम ऑफ अजामिल व्हेन ही केप्ट द फर्स्ट नेम ऑफ ईशान नारायण एंड इफ इन ऑल पाप्स सिंस वेर गॉन देन व्हाई ही लीव अगेन अगेन ओ विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती था देन That all the name, all the sin after first name, what we see, they were like a burnt robe. Robe which had been burnt and something is there like this. Shape of the robe is there, but if you touch what it will be? Oh. There is no robe, nothing. It is seen. Or if you can take the poison of it, like poison is a snake, and if it does like this, bites, no poison. So the poison has been taken. So what Ajami did, it was poison, fruitless. But general person can imagine this. Why not? There are no realization. If you are chanting name, now yesterday, you are chanting. You are saying that no effect is coming. But those who are realized persons, they will see that, oh, action is going on. Some soap is going on the soul, but we are not here. It may be that is all sins, all offenses have gone, but even these very sins like cruel or some harsh words or something, but no violence. His soul has become pure. And it may be that after this, his death, oh, now he will come in a very good family of devotee family. And from beginning, all these systems of Vaishnava will be seen. So we can see. But something good. If you are doing Namavasi then, with the Shraddha, then action is going on and general person is not watching. But even if you go. If there is no offense, Vaishnava, then and if Vaishnava, it will take time.
শুদ্ধ নাম করে দিয়ে তার প্রেম পর্যন্ত হয়েছিল যাই
बिना प्रेम होले बैकुंठ से जाते है आश्चर्य प्रेम वही साधु मुक्त महापुरुष अपराध करे नहीं वैष्णव निंदा करे है तो धार्मिक कुछ पाप हो respect to wishing that oh he's like the person to be gentle. So peaceful. Try to be very careful. There are so many persons they don't know Nama Prada or any then Namaha. Perfection devotees is maybe that they can do Namaha. For Indian devotees, what is very hard? Because they are in touch of Mayavadi. They know, from beginning they know Vaishnava Tattva, Guru Tattva, something. And knowingly if they are doing, then Namaha. And not knowingly if doing, then Namaha.
That means ignorance is bliss.
What? अज्ञानता कुछ वैष्णव के संग में आ जाने से वो थोड़ा सा यदि अपराध हो तो वो क्षमे किंतु अज्ञानता तब जान बुझ करके जो ही करे बहुत से लोग जान बुझ करके आगे चल सकते जानते हैं कि वैष्णव का निंदा नहीं करना है तो अभी लौकिक स्वार्थ के लिए वो करते हैं नहीं देयर आर सो मेनी डिवोटी They are in association, good association. They know what is Nama, Nama Bhash, Nama Prat, they know. But even knowing it, for sake of their worldly desires, Pratishtha, and all other things. Oh, they think that we are bound to do a prat, to save our mission. Right? Oh, that I told. I've given that. You should write
it.
इसलिए कि वो अभ्यास जो कर रहा था अभ्यास के द्वारा कर रहा पर अभ्यास के द्वारा Like, oh, for example, there was a thief. But anyhow, he came in the touch of Ramanu. And Ramanu gave him Harinama and Diksha. And he now knew that this to thief, to steal away, offended. He left everything. But, oh, a practice for 60 years. Now they have left that move, but they used to change the cloth of Vaishnava. To change here and that here. To see what becomes, and when they used to confide well, stolen away my cloth, and you have stolen, and they used to somewhat quarrel, and same these things used to be happen. Like this. No mood of state, but yet. So there are some things like this. But yes, sir. Hey. Uspa jepa chan, uspa jepa Uska ki tu kriya ko kori ki jana. Oh. एक बात को ठीक रखना, यहाँ पर कहा गया अर्चन अपेक्षा नामेर स्मरण कीर्तन अति श्रेष्ठ। अर्चन की अपेक्षा नाम के स्मरण और कीर्तन को बहुत श्रेष्ठ बनता है। तो किंतु इसका मतलब ये मत निकाल लो जो कोई चैलेंज देकर के कह रहा है कि अर्चन मत करो। बहुत से लोग ऐसा समझते थे स्मरण एंड कीर्तन ऑफ नाम इज मोर सुपीरियर देन अर्चन, बट इट हैज नॉट टोल्ड एंड इट हैज नॉट बीन चैलेंज्ड दैट यू शुड नॉट डू अर्चन। नो, वो अपने अधिकार के अनुसार करने के लिए बाध्य है। लाभ पाओगे नहीं वो जब उसका अधिकार नाम कर्तन में जबकि उची हो जाएगी समझ जाएगा तो अपने आप वो समझ जाएगा। या अर्चन भी करेगा तो उसका अर्चन रघुनाथ दास को सभी जैसे वो भाव सेवा हो जाएगा, वैसा ही करेगा, वैसा ही करेगा। और कभी कभी वो भी नहीं होगा यदि भावाविष्ट होकर के मूर्छित हो गए और कृष्ण नाम लेते ही महाप्रभु जैसा भाव आया नाम और गलगल हो गए तो कौन अर्चन करेगा, कौन करेगा। इसलिए तो चैतन्य महाप्रभु ने रघुनाथ दास को दे और रघुनाथ गोस्वामी जब तक उनका वो सवाल था तब तक किया इसके बाद में नहीं
that if the chanting of Harinam and chanting of remembering is far superior to Archan, then we should leave Archan, we should give up Archan. This is not the correct conclusion. Actually, everyone should practice their sadhana according to their adhikar. So, this Archan is helpful for those who are chanting now. But those who come in a high stage, they have no chance to do Archan because they become so absorbed. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was doing Archana of Govardhan Shila, but because his mood was so high, after some time he gave that Govardhan Shila, and we've had darshan of that Govardhan Shila today at the temple of Radha Shamsunda. Then Radha Gokulananda. There, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has given this Govardhan Shila to Raghunath Das Goswami when they are in Puri. And Raghunath Das Goswami, he began doing Archana to this Govardhan Shila. But actually, he was serving in a very, very high mood, only worshipping with 8 tulsi leaves, tulsi mandiris, and with some water. And also, later in his life, also he left this archan, becoming more and more deeply absorbed in his bhajan.
Jab tak sharir aur man ka sadhak se sambandh rehta hai, usme ashakta rehta hai, tab tak kanishth gat adhikar hai. उसमें उसको जो यदि वो नाम भी करता है तो वो भी अर्चन, वो कुछ भी काम वैष्णव सेवा भी करता है तो वो अर्चन, वो बात है उसकी क्रिया ऐसी। और जहाँ वो स्वाभाविक रूप में सप्त शुद्ध यदि यहाँ पर आ गया तो उसका जो कुछ अर्चन और जो कुछ भी करेगा उसका वो भाव वही भक्ति हो जाएगी। जैसे वो विश्वनाथ चतुर्थी ठाकुर से भाव वही वैसे भाव भक्ति एक ऐसी चीज है जिसको आरंभ मात्र किया यदि बीच में छूट गया मर गया भक्ति की सिद्धि नहीं हुई, नाम की सिद्धि नहीं हुई, अर्चन की सिद्धि नहीं हुई, किंतु आरंभ कर दिया बस साधु संघ में गुरु पदार्थ लेकर अब उसका पथ चला। बीच में वो छूट गया कोई आदमी किसी तरह से हृदय वीक होने से ये चीज नहीं और ही कहेंगे नो अगेन फ्रॉम अनदर पार्टी विल बी प्रत्यवायुन स्वल्पमपि अस्य धर्मस्य ये सब दुख का दृश्य भगवान के चरण में मत कीजिए बेटा. अंडरस्टैंड यू बट आई डोंट व्हाई इन श्रीमद् भागवत वन श्लोक हैज बीन टोल्ड एक तो श्रीमद् भागवत स्कोर यदि अपने वर्णाश्रम धर्म को उसने त्याग कर दिया और उसे यदि वो क्या
वर्णाश्रम धर्म को छोड़कर कोई भगवान का भजन करता है
और
भजन करते करते यदि शरीर का पतन हो गया
अवस्था में
भजन की सिद्धि नहीं हुई और शरीर छूट गया तो ऐसी स्थिति में कोई अमंगल नहीं होता है
उसका अर्थ क्या है क्या है कुछ
गोवार्थ आप तो भजता हूँ सधर्म तो परंतु जिसने भगवान का भजन नहीं किया पर सधर्म का पालन किया तो उसे
लाभ कौन
सा लाभ होगा क्या कल्याण होगा कुछ नहीं मिलेगा
पर पार्टी घर हर बार
देखो 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 देखो
देखो देखो देखो देखो देखो देखो देखो देखो देखो
One thing you said before was not translation, I mentioned, and come to this. Buddha also mentioned previously, who was not translated, that if someone is neophyte and they have connection with the material body, then all their chanting and everything also included in Archa. Now we're coming to the point, in Srimad Bhagavatam, Chakta Sodharam Charanam Bhujam Haraya, in this verse, it is stated that if one they leave all of their responsibilities of this world in Varnashram Dharma. For what reason? To take up the process of devotional service. And they're making some advancement, but they have not attained perfection. And somehow or other, they become deviated from the path. They give up their practices, or they die. So for any reason, they may leave their devotional service. Yet still, for that person, falling down in an immature stage of their development, there's no loss at all for them. One should not be afraid of this. On the other hand, if one follows all the rules and regulations of Varnashram Dharma, but neglects the lotus feet of Krishna and does not engage himself in Shuddha Bhakti, then what gain does he get? Absolutely nothing. So Srimad Bhagavatam is encouraging everyone, oh, try to come in the path of Bhajan. There is no loss of diminution on this path.
One thing here. That is the question. If a Vaishnav putting tilak, kanthi mala, and observing the basic principle of bhakti, following, and if he is disobeying any Vaishnav, कोई वैष्णव का अनादर करता है उनकी निंदा करता है उनको गाली गलौज करता है वैष्णव को और ये ठीक है कि एक आदमी वैष्णव का ये सब कुछ धारण करके भी उनकी निंदा नहीं करता है मांस मछली भले ही खा लिया परिणाम करना छोड़ दिया तो वैष्णव का निंदा कभी नहीं किया पहले नहीं किया अभी नहीं करता है मांस मछली खा लिया दोनों में कौन कठिन है वैष्णव बोले तिलक माला धारण करें आप वैष्णव निंदा करते और एक किलो ऐसा कुछ थकले वैष्णव निंदा करे ना वो प्याज लहसुन की मांस मछली खेल लो हरिनाम का रास्ता छेड़ लो What? सेंट वैष्णव डॉन टू वैष्णव पर एक आदमी हरिनाम कर रहा है, बहुत चेष्टा किया बीड़ी नहीं छूटी, बहुत चेष्टा किया, यदि छोड़ता है तो बीमार पड़ जाता है। तो उसको क्या करना चाहिए, हरिनाम छोड़ देना चाहिए कि जैसे तैसे उसको हरिनाम जारी रखना चाहिए? पार्टी छोड़ो, पार्टी छोड़ो, हाँ हरिनाम को देखा पे बैठे
कोई भगवान का भजन करता है और करते करते विकर्म जनचोत पतितम कथन चेत, कभी किसी प्रकार से कोई विकर्म जो निषिद्ध कर्म ऐसा कर्म हो जाता है तो उसके लिए कोई प्रायश्चित नहीं है। स्वपाद मूलम भजत कृतार्थ भाव हरि परेश, क्योंकि उसने सारे दूसरे भाव को, दूसरे देव देवी का पूजन अर्चन आदि छोड़कर एकमात्र श्री कृष्ण का भजन कर रहे हैं। हरि परेश क्योंकि भगवान श्री हरि उनके हृदय में अवस्थित हैं, उनके हृदय के जावतीय मलिनता सब कुछ विनोद कर देते हैं।
भक्ति जो से आगे भ्रष्ट जो हो गए विकर्म के लिए, और फिर वो उसे जन्म लेंगे और अपने पापों का थोड़ा सा फल भोग लेंगे, यही उनके लिए प्रायश्चित। और जब दंड नहीं देगा, कौन देगा? ये प्रभु ही जो इच्छा होगी वो अपना करेगा और उसको फिर अच्छे कुल में जन्म दे करके भक्ति में भी उसको देगा। ले जाएंगे वो भगवान ही, जैसे जमराज जी ने कहा है वो हमारे अधीन नहीं है, उसको दंड दंड देना होगा, जो कुछ करना होगा क्षमा होगा हम करेंगे, उन लोगों का अधिकार, इसलिए उसको दुख भी देते हैं। यहाँ तक कि शुद्ध भक्तों को भी जान बुझ करके भक्ति में उत्कर्ष के लिए उसको दुख देते हैं। कर्म फल तो नष्ट हो गया, कैसे बचेगा? भगवान उसमें लगा उसकी भक्ति की वृद्धि है।
Now, Srila Gurudev is posing a very interesting question. Now, Srila Gurudev is posing an interesting question to help us understand the power of Shuddha Bhakti and Harinam. He's saying that there are two people. One devotee is wearing tilak, kantimala, and following all the regulative principles very, very strictly. But he's not following the order of Guru and Vaishnavas. Neglecting them, criticizing them also, and making offenses in this way. On the other hand, there's another personality. He's left his practices, and he's gone into a life, now he's eating fish, and breaking the regulative principles because his heart was so weak, he had no strength to follow. So, but he's very a simple person and he's not making any offense to any Vaishnava. So, of these two, who is in the most precarious condition? Who is in a dangerous position? And who is rightly situated? Who is situated in the best position of these two? So the conclusion is, the person who is fallen and breaking so many principles, but he's not making any offense, he is in a better condition than the other person. So, Srila Gurudev is saying, we don't give stress on these things. If they break the principles and then they are finished, we should put stress on this thing. What? That you should not commit any offense at the lotus feet of Guru and Vaishnavas. This will make a very severe impediment and check our progress for lifetimes. But if someone will fall, but they're very simple and they don't make offense, this will not be a very severe impediment. So, Gurudev gave the example, if someone is smoking, and they try to give up smoking, they make very hard endeavor to give up smoking. And they, when they give up by the hard endeavor, then they become sick. And they can't do anything.
It means not that I'm permitting you to take cigarettes. Don't think like, I'm not saying that you to take flesh, eggs and everything, you are permitted. Don't think.
But anyway, even if smoking, no harm, he should start his bhajan, he should chant Harinam, and what will be the result of that? So, there's a verse in Swapada Moolam, this verse from Srimad Bhagavatam. In this verse, it says that if someone will practice bhakti, even though they may be fallen, if they don't make any offense, then Krishna himself, he will come in their heart and he will remove all their obstacles and problems. So there's no need of any kind of prasthita. Krishna himself will remove all obstacles. Vishnu Chakritapo said that when he leaves his body, Yamaraj will not punish him at all. What will happen? Sujinam Srimatangehe. In his next life, he'll take a very good birth in a wealthy family or in a religious family, and that problem will be, it will have gone, and he will make progress in his spiritual life. Still, some suffering may come to him. This is not from karma, Krishna, this, and also not from Yamaraj, no suffering will come from him. It will be applied by Krishna himself, like a medicine, to increase his eagerness and cause his tendency to serve to go higher and higher and higher.
मुक्त महापुरुषों के किया था तो पर he has heard from Reverend Nitya Lila from Vishnu Bhashish Matbhakti Pramod Kuni Maharaj and he said what he has heard.
तो कहते थे कि सभी लोग मठ में आए, सभी लोग मठ में आए हैं प्यास
में,
सभी लोग प्याज लहसुन मांस मछली छोड़ करके मठ में रहने लगे हैं। तो हम लोगों ने मांस मछली छुड़ाना क्यों उनको छुड़ाया? सिर्फ इसलिए कि उनके अंदर तमोगुण बुद्धि ना आए। परंतु यदि वो हम मांस मछली क्यों नहीं खाते, क्योंकि उससे क्या होता है, उनको कष्ट पहुंचता है, हम उनका खून पीते हैं, उनको काटते हैं। तो इसी तरह से यदि हम उस मांस को खाना छोड़ करके वैष्णव का मांस खाना शुरू कर देंगे तो हमारी क्या गति होगी? वैष्णव में किस तरह वैष्णव का मांस किस तरह से खाएंगे? उनकी निंदा करके, उनको दुख दे करके, उनके खून को जला करके, इस तरह से यदि हम वैष्णव को दुख देंगे तो हमारी क्या गति होगी? यदि उसको खाने से हमारी गति बहुत ही खराब होती है तो इसको खाने से हमारी गति कभी भी अच्छी होगी नहीं।
In English. Why you are? You know
English. My Gurudev used to say that once he heard from Srila Prabhupada that Srila Prabhupada told that all the devotees who came to the mart, we tell them to give up all this onion, garlic, flesh, fish, etc. We tell them to give up all these things. Why? Because by eating all those things, they get tamasic buddhi, ignorance. And if a person who gives up all these things and he eats the flesh of Vaishnavas in the form of criticizing them, giving them problems, disturbing them in different ways, if he do that, then what will be his destination? If by eating those things, he will get tamoguna buddhi, and by eating this, then what kind of buddhi he will get? And after that, how it's possible? husband that he will do bhajan and how he will become surrendered to his devotee, his Gurudev.
We are against getting tea, coffee, but we are not against criticizing Vaishnav, chastising Vaishnav, offending Vaishnav. This very high class of Vaishnav. We should try to. But I am not permitting them that you should take tea, coffee and all. No. Jena, Janmashatai, Urbam, Vasteva Samarjitam, Tanmukhe Harinamani, Sadastishtam, Oh, first once, Pavatansa Bharat, Jinhone Shaino Janmo Me, Samachit Rukhse Vasteki Ka Achan Kiya Hai, Vasudev Bhakyan Se, Unke Mukh Me, Harinam Ka Nitya, Naam Kirai Sarata. But,
this verse is quoted in Hari Bhakti Vilas. In this verse, Yena Janma Mashatai Purvam, he states that, hey, best of the Bharat dynasty, that person who is very perfectly performed archan to Lord Vasudev in thousands of previous lives, the name of Sri Hari will constantly reside upon his tongue.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur is translation kar rahe hain, baat kar rahe hain. Hare Krishna 16 naam ashtayuga hai. Ashtayuga arthe ashtlok prabhu hai. Bhaktivinoda Thakur karte hain ki Hare Krishna इसमें 32 अक्षर 16 नाम और 8 युगल हिंदी शाही नाम कमिंग फ्रॉम कलिशंतर्ण उपनिषद वेद दिस हैज 32 लेटर्स 16 नेम्स एंड 8 pairs. Eight pairs? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for this is combining the shlok, ashtar shlok for ashtar shlok. It will take time to explain. Tomorrow I will explain. Now I am telling Maldiji. The subject is very great, very deep. हम लोग इस subject को समझ बुझ करके हरिनाम करें, अनंत छोड़ करके, गुरु पदाश्रय करके, संबंध ज्ञान शक्त होकर और अपराधों से दूर रख करके बहुत जल्दी कृपाई अपने आप पूरा करें. The effective shelter of the bona fide guru, always following him and serving him, always in his association and guidance, with the relation, not that we are serving, or more than that relation, and then doing chanting Hari name in the way that Bhaktivinoda Thakur shows. Very soon we have Braja Prince, not only, not as Braja Prince, but we will try to explain it tomorrow. So now our class is finished. Tomorrow we will go for that. Achha, Shyam Sundar ke chhad dena. Aate jaate samay jekhane ho par. Tomorrow, we go Gopinath, Dheer Shami, Banshi Bhat, Rashastari, Gopishwar Mahadev, and returning Govindji, बनखंडी महादेव एंड इफ यू कैन डू श्याम अदरवाइज एनी टाइम यू कैन पे दैट यू कैन पे दर्शन ऑफ श्याम एंड डे आफ्टर टुमारो यू विल गो वेरी मॉर्निंग टू ब्रह्मराज the places of Mahapur Khan but and fair Shah Krishna and Bhadde and also all the books they shall go to Rupinda go to there also Mahapur not there he was there Mahapur Khan This is somebody, the place of story of breath. So, if you go to this place, you will come and go to this place. And we will go from here at 6:30. At 6:30 we will start from here. And I want to come within night. Those who can not walk, they can take some. And when we will return at once, we will sit there and we will do archan, Pushpanjali, and we will speak, we will glorify. So this program. I request to the devotees who are somewhat related so much to me, to like the and Shyamala. And Champa Prata, they should take some prominent part to decorate the earth we had to do. And all can be. You should get ready. And glorify the earth. Some arrangement to be done for Prasada and Jari.
Hare Krishna, for the kind attention of devotees, we have registered their name for initiation. Initiation will take place tomorrow 8:30 a.m. Who will take initiation, they should not go for darshan. So they will come in first floor near Sevakunj. And 9:30 will be fire sacrifice by Sripad Gan Maharaj and Krishna Kishore Brajavasi. Hare Krishna, who will take initiation, they will not go tomorrow in darshan, they will come in front of Guru Vishnu in Sevakunj, 8:30 a.m. After initiation, hapan fire sacrifice will be 9:30 a.m.
खाने पीने के बाद में घंटा विश्राम करके आकर
Hare Krishna. I have a few announcements for everyone. Devotees who need help because they are sick, there is a doctor here, as you may have heard before. Every afternoon at 4:15, the doctor will be in this room here. You can come and get your medicines and advice. Between 5:30 and 7 o'clock in the evening, there is a homeopathic doctor. The first one is allopathic, Homeopathic doctor is just outside the mass. If you go out of the gate and you turn left, then it is the third house, green door. Turn out, go out of the main door, left, third door.
Red.
Then we want to...
Red door.
These are people just beside the Radha Damodara temple. And this is where they say. See? You can see.
Oh my God.
Oh, Oh. Thank you.